Hello, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video. And this time I want to create a very, very dramatic image and generally just make this a lot darker with a very strong bloom effect in the center part and also rather desaturated color tones. Now the base image isn't very interesting, but since the editing for this shot is really, really cool, I think it's worth sharing this video with you. For the editing, I will be using Adobe Lightroom. So before I start editing, let's first take a look at the before and after images. So here we are in Lightroom, and this image I'm working on right now is an HDR panoramic image. That means I have merged a bracketed series. You can see it down here. I have simply selected them all, right clicked on them, and then photo merge HDR panorama. And I ended up with this shot as my base image. To start editing, I'm changing the camera profile to Adobe Standard first. I'm not touching the white balance since I like the color tone of the image. But as I want the image to be dark, I'm first dropping the exposure. Next, I want to reveal some detail in the brighter area above the horizon right there. So I'm dropping the highlights. Since this is an HDR image, we have a lot of dynamic range to work with, so we can reveal more detail. I probably will overexpose this area later for a nice glowing effect, but for now, we have some nice details restored from there. Then next, I want to slightly increase the whites and add some clarity, but only very, very careful here. And since I want this image to be a little less saturated, I'm also dropping the vibrance. Okay, that's it for the basic adjustments. Now for this image, there's a lot going on with local adjustments. So let's first take the gradiated filters. I usually use them for the foreground and the sky. Just like in this case, I want to make the sky darker, so I dragged one over the whole part here. And then let's just drop the exposure quite a bit. Then let's boost the contrast. And let's also boost the clarity. And this will just make the clouds a little more interesting. Okay, then for the foreground, I also want to boost the details in here. So I'm adding some texture and some clarity. And that's it for the gradiated filters. Next, I want to work on the radial filters. Let's start with adjusting the pond in the foreground. I want to make it a little brighter, so I'm bringing up the whites. And also let's add some more detail by increasing the clarity. Okay, nice. Then next, I want to apply some fake vignetting. Here, I'm using this radial filter. And outside of it, I'm dropping the whites, which will darken the areas. Then comes my favorite part with adding the glow to the image. You can see I have applied two smaller radial filters over the brightest parts of the sky. And for those two, I'm simply increasing the blacks. And I'm also dropping the dehaze. And by doing this, Lightroom will add a nice Lightroom effect. So let's repeat this on the other radial filter, increase the blacks, drop the dehaze. And you can see this looks really, really cool. Then I have one radial filter left, and that's just a bigger one for a lot more glow. Again, I'm increasing the blacks, but this time I'm not going all the way up here. Also, I'm dropping the dehaze again. And now the light bloom effect will become very, very visible, as you can see. We can further increase this effect by increasing the whites. And as I said earlier, there now is a lot of overexposure going on, but I think in this shot it works quite good this way. So I might want to introduce some more warmth to this area by increasing the temperature. And that's basically it for the local adjustments. Then let's do a little bit of color grading. First, I want to boost the luminance in the green tones, which will make the foreground just a little brighter. Then let's switch to the saturation. I'm going to drop the green saturation a little bit, but instead boost the yellows and the orange tones, and maybe also the blue tones. Then for the split toning, I'm going to apply a warm color tone to the highlights, and of course a colder one for the shadows. Now I think the highlights are a little bit too much here, so I'm dropping the balance. That means the highlights will get less affected than the shadows by the split toning. And I think it looks really cool this way. Finally, of course, I want to sharpen the image a little bit. And that's it for editing this dramatic mountain landscape image. So I hope this was helpful and interesting. Of course, if you have any questions, then please feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.